Have you ever wandered lonely through the woods? And everything that feels just as it should. You're part of a life there, you're part of something good. If you've ever wandered lonely through the woods. Ooh. If you've ever wandered lonely through the woods. Have you ever stared into a starry sky? Lying on your back, you're asking why. What's the purpose? I wonder who am I? If you've ever stared into a starry sky.
Friends, it's been a while. It has been a while. Yes, it has. We have been silent, but hardly idle. No, no, more Axe science than ever, more Axe activity than ever going on. Here, just had to take a little break from the videos, get some stuff done, okay? Just get some stuff done. Did you see the footage of the swamp people chopping the woods? Chopping the woods out of their boats, right? Springboard champions, every one of them. Springboard, go back there in about 2 minutes. See the swamp guys. Chopping it up. And, you know, is that the origin of the swamping pattern? Perhaps. Is there some connection? Is that where the swamping pattern was developed? Out in the swamps? Right? With the Cajuns and the whatnots down there chopping down the cypress or what? Okay? But it's time to get back into it. And I'm ready for the second axe axiom. Okay? You may recall, buried in the footage on this channel, right? The first axe axiom, right? The first axe axiom. And let's review what the first axe axiom was. The first axe axiom that I proposed, right, was a great handle can make a big axe feel small and a small axe chop big. And I stick by that. I'm 100% all in on this axiom. It is true. All the Axe arenas confirm this. All the new designs I've tried confirm this. The handle is so key. It is so key to carrying the weight. And it is really the user experience, okay? It is the user experience of an axe, right? The handle, way more than the head and the pattern and the steel and those things. The handle will decide whether you're having a good day of chopping or not. But you know, I've been out, you know, after the Axe arenas, I just went out chopping, right? And here's, you know, I got some footage of, you know, just my days getting back out there just to train. You know, sometimes I go out there and, you know, I don't film anything. I just go out there and chop, right? It's very therapeutic, very lovely, great time, great workout. It's just good to get in the woods, use these axes, learn things. It's a lot of fun. So, you know, I've been working on accuracy lately. You know, that came up a lot. How important the accuracy is. And it has led me to the point where I'm ready to proffer the second X axiom, which may actually have to be the first X axiom. This might have to be number one. This is not a developed science. This is where science is an ongoing conversation, right? You have to revise your theses all the time. This may be the first X axiom, and the one about handles may be number two, okay? The second X axiom is power strokes the ego, accuracy cuts the wood. Now wait, before you all give a collective sigh. Oh, that's the X axiom. Geez, Sisyphus, tell us something we don't know. Tell us something we don't know, right? None of this, bend like a reed, flow like water, mumbo jumbo, right? Give us a design axiom, something hard to stand on. Power strokes the ego, accuracy cuts the wood. I know, it pushes the responsibility back on the user. Now it's not the axe's fault, it's the user's fault. We don't like that. That's not helpful, right? Yes, of course, everyone knows this, right? We say this all the time, accuracy, accuracy. But do you know it? Do you really know it, right? I thought I knew this, a year ago. With Axe Arena Group A, right? I wander off in the woods with, three axes, and let's do a video, why not, right? Accuracy is important, and I wasn't very accurate, right? But I got better. I did not know it until I know it now, and I may not even still know how important this is. This is actually essential to the whole process of cutting wood. For the most part, at least for me, my focus on power was directly proportional to my ignorance of how to actually chop wood, right? When I first started out, that was all about power. That was all about muscles. That was about hitting that wood as hard as you can. The harder you hit it, the faster you're through it. Seems logical, right? That's how I started out. Then, we did the Efficient Axe series. We read Dudley Cook, right? We did some axe arenas. We designed some new axes, blah, blah, blah. But now my eyes have been opened to a key insight, truly, after many hours on the wood, it is. Accuracy's it. It's all about it. Power can be wasted. I want to go back to long-handled axes, okay? If you watch the axe arenas, you will have noticed, right? Throughout the axe arenas, we would have lots of long-handled axes, right? Axes with 34, 35, 36-inch handles on them. Very, very common. You can get them today. In fact, it's sort of like the expected standard handle on a full-size felling axe for the most part, right? Go shop around. You're going to find 34-inch, 35-inch, 36-inch, right? That's what you're going to find paired with a 4.5, 4-pound axe. That's what you find is a full-size felling axe, right? Manly stuff, all right? None of this boys' axe stuff. None of this bushcrafting stuff, right? We're out there chopping wood like the old-timers, okay? These big axes. But every time, right, one of these long-handled designs would go up against something shorter, something 32, 30 inches, 29 inches, the shorter handles would kill it, thus leading to what was the first axe axiom, right? A great handle can make a big axe feel small, right? A big axe feel small, and a small axe chop big. You get a right handle on there, and the weight of the head is just so much more efficient. Just so much. What was going on in all that? What was going on? What prompted that insight? And why were the Axe Arena winners? The better axes always these shorter axes. Let's go back to the long handles. Let's go back to long handles during my training. I'm going to get these long handles out there. They're still gangly. They still feel weird. But there's some physical reasons why this is the case, right? There's some physical reasons why longer handled axes are more difficult to use, okay? And for all the potential benefits suggested in their design, in truth, they're washed out because of degradation in how accurate you can be. They're less accurate. I mean, let me show you why. It's physics. There's a physical reason. So to begin with, it's worth asking, why did they like long handles in the first place? If you collect axes, if you're a collector, a picker, right? There's a 90% chance at least, okay, you find an old vintage axe in the wild. It's got one of those great heads on it, right? A True Temper, Man, all these great names, American Swiss. It didn't matter where it came from. Chances are it was a full-sized head, 3.5, 4.5 pounds. It had a 34 to 36 inch handle on it. Right? Right? Collectors, am I right? You know, you go out there, you find them. You know, this was the expected length of a full-sized axe, clearly, through, you know, the golden age of the, you know, 20th century forestry. That's just how they came still to this day. And it's where they, why? Why, if they're, you know, if they're harder to use and it takes more practice, why was that the length of handle recommended with these axes? And it's easy. One word, power. So let's imagine that we have three axes, right, of different lengths, right? Same sized head. The head's exactly the same, okay? And the shape and geometry of the handle is the same. It's just all that's zeroed out. The only difference between these three axes is the length of the handle, right? Let's say 28, 32, and 36 inches. And all three of the axes are going to pivot on the same point, right? They're going to swing on the exact same point, which is in exactly like a real human swing of an axe, but just for physics purposes here, right? They swing the same way, in the same plane, on the same pivot, okay? So to see why longer axes can be more powerful, all else being equal, you have to understand the difference between angular velocity and linear velocity, which that sounds all sciencey, but really just think of a door. Think of a door swinging on a hinge, right? Okay? Door swings on a hinge, door swings on a hinge. The whole door swings through the same angle. Let's say it's 90 degrees, right? Swings through the whole 90 degrees at the same speed, okay? Meaning the wood right on the hinge, okay, right on the hinge, goes through 90 degrees at exactly the same time, right? Exactly the same time as the end of the door where the knob is. It swings like that there. But if you know, you're like, this is intuitive, right? The linear speed, the actual speed through space at different points on the door are different. The wood at the very edge by the knob out at the end is traveling faster through space than the wood right next to the hinge, right? I mean, we see this, we know this. That's the difference between, like, they swing through the same angle, but they're swinging at different linear velocities, which is very analogous now to our three axes. See, the same thing is happening, right? Swinging these three axes, all else being equal, right? All else being equal, we swing the same axis. They're going to travel through the angle, right? Let's say 90 degrees, hits the log at 90 degrees. And they just travel through that angle at the same time, right? They all get there at the same time, but they're traveling at different speeds. The longer axe is going farther in the same time, so it's going faster. See how that is? Now, I know there might be some engineers out there going to quibble on all kinds of things. It's just, this is a very broad illustration of just the principle, okay? Not the pure mechanical solution. But you can see the longer axe is traveling faster through the swing, right? When it hits the wood, it is going faster when it gets there than the 28-inch handle, right? So speed equals power. That's actually a physical law. That's a physical law. Force equals mass times acceleration. Acceleration being speed. They're the same thing, right? Whether they're measured in miles per hour, meters per second, whatever, you know, acceleration, speed. So the weight of the object times its speed equals the force, which is power, which is what we're talking about, a power, you know, with an axe. It's more force. More force hits the wood. Now, I actually consulted with some, you know, physicists, right? Actual physicists and some math people. Like, okay, let's calculate this out. What are we talking about here? You know, more force, right? And so, assuming a swing of 50 miles per hour, which is fairly reasonable, I did some research. That is pretty close, maybe 50 miles an hour, right? Which is 22.4 meters per second, right? Go out here and you calculate this. Okay, what would be the distance through that swing? A 90 degree angle, 50 miles per hour. What happens with a 4-pound head, right? If mass equals 4 pounds, what happens, all right? Now check that out. So using 28 inches as sort of the baseline, 28 baseline, the 32-inch handle hits with 8.5% more power. There's more accelerate, 8.5%. Okay, we're pretty sure this is right. It seemed right. We went through it a million times, but 8.5% faster. And then the 36 handle, it actually starts to go up. You know, it starts to go up really fast. It's 28% more. Okay. So now wait, think about that. 28% more power. Now, if I were to offer you a fuel additive that you could put in your car or motorcycle that for a few pennies, right, would add 28% more power, you throw money at that idea, right? That's a significant amount more power. That really is. And, you know, and that is the thinking behind longer axes. You're getting quite a bit more power with just a few more inches, right? Just a few more inches. What's the big deal? It's just, a few cents worth of wood. Put it out there. Get that power. Oh, no, 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 right? It's like getting one of those genie's wishes. There's a genie's wish, right? There's always a shadow side. There's always a shadow side to all this power, okay? And you can see why the danger. You can see the danger. By now, let's look at the axe from the top down through the swing. So for all kinds of reasons, there's all kinds of reasons, but our swing gets off from the aim point. We're not going to hit it there. We're off by a degree or 2 degrees or maybe even just half a degree, but we're a little bit off, right? Now, the length of the handle is a detriment. It's a liability because the farther out we go, the same amount of error in your swing, 0.5%, 1%, is now magnified. It's getting bigger. It's increasing, okay? For example, if you're just 1 degree off, okay, just 1 degree off, 28-inch handle is going to land basically half an inch from the aim point, half an inch from the aim point. And then it goes up from there, 32-inch, 5.6, 36-inch, 6.3, okay? Let's go back to the second axe axiom. Let's go back, right? Power strokes the ego, accuracy cuts the wood. You might argue at this point, Mr. Sisyphus, what is a tenth of an inch compared to a 28% increase in power? What is 4 millimeters off when you can get so much power? Wouldn't that power, a lot of the time, overcome the error and just kind of plow through that wood, just kind of chunk it up, right, and mush it, right? So it's better in that case that you have more power, even if you are more accurate. I will concede that there are probably in very soft green wood. Maybe that's true. You know, really soft wood, mushy stuff, right? If you ever chop this stuff, it's like you can do no wrong. I mean, it's like a watermelon. It's great. It's a great experience, right? But that is not your typical situation. And, you know, that's nothing like hardwoods or dry dead wood, you know, and stuff you process for firewood. No, that's not true. All I can offer at this point, truly, and offer at this point is that is not true, right? This is what I've learned, you know, in a year and a half of, you know, just going out and testing axes once against the other and actually trying over amount of time to get more accurate. I am here to tell you the power is not worth it. Accuracy trumps power 90% of the time, right? And when it doesn't, it's because you just found some, you know, golden honeywood that it's a chopper's paradise, okay? Not typical, not typical. It is not worth it. So, this is why, I think, right? When there were a lot of professional woodsmen, loggers, timbermen actually out there using axes daily, they were much more accurate. They were much more efficient. And to cater to those professional buyers, right, it made sense. They liked 34, 36 inches. It is a sweet spot. I could see getting used to it. I really could. You use it every day. You will get more accurate, and then that power kicks in. That's great. But really, for the rest of us, for average people, there are not many people like that. And even, you know, even people who chop a lot, unless you've really worked on your accuracy and you're really focused on cuts, you might be surprised, you know, when you try to do it, it's just a new process, okay? So I stand by my axiom for the moment. I stand by my axiom that power strokes the ego, accuracy cuts the wood. It is the accuracy that's doing the cutting. It's doing the work, okay? Power is awesome when you're hitting where you aim. It is awesome. Well, in that case, the more power, the better, once you're accurate. That's really what I've learned. You know, of course we want more power, but accuracy is really the key to axe performance, okay? So, you know, in a way, this rolls all the way back into some of the research we did, you know, with the work axes. Well, you know, that whole idea was like these shorter axes feel so much more comfortable. You feel like you're in control. You have more awareness. Your tempo is higher with the same amount of effort. A lot of benefits. It's a lot of benefits in just getting the work done. You know, cutting well, being an awesome axe. This is great. So that the job is kind of fun instead of the job sucking. All right? And, well, who wants a job that sucks? We don't want to do wood chopping jobs that suck. We want our wood chopping jobs to be awesome. We want it to be a good time. Okay? High performance.
Well, that's friends. I hope you enjoyed that. A little bit of science. Hope you learned something. Always trying to explore new topics with the axes, right? And I just want to say, if you were to look around in my axe studio today, this is the last transmission from the axe studio. Yeah, this is it. This is it. My workshop is stripped bare, moving to a new location. All that's left of this tiny corner of axe memorabilia, right? So the studio's got to come down. I got to move all the axes over and reconfigure in a new location. Very exciting things coming. Very exciting things. If you're into axes, you're going to want to keep up with this channel. Some pretty exciting things coming down the pike. I don't think you'll want to miss them, right? I'm excited about them. So tune in next time. See you later.